trying to relax you and guide you into a deep slumber. Along with our stories, the background of soothing nature sounds, gentle music, and calming sound effects is designed to enhance the quality of your sleep. We are here to help you shed the day's stress and fatigue, guiding you to a peaceful sleep. Now, close your eyes, relax, and enjoy our stories that will transport you to another world. In the vast tapestry of Greek mythology, the story of creation emerges not from order, but from chaos, a boundless and formless abyss that predates existence itself. This primordial void, known simply as chaos, is the genesis of all life, the birthing ground from which the fundamental forces and divine entities of the universe spring forth. In this nascent stage of creation, the cosmos is devoid of structure, law, and life as we know it. Yet, within this void lies the potential for order, complexity, and divinity. From chaos, the first deities emerge, marking the dawn of existence and the beginning of cosmic order. Among these primordial beings are Gaia, the Earth, embodying the solid foundation upon which all life would stand, Uranus, the sky, a symbol of the heavens and the infinite space above, and Tartarus, the deep abyss below, representing the unknown depths of the Earth. These initial entities represent the cornerstones of the world, the physical and metaphysical elements that form the basis of the universe. The union of Gaia and Uranus catalyzes the next phase of creation, bringing forth a new generation of divine beings, the Titans. These powerful entities are the forebearers of many gods and goddesses that would come to inhabit Olympus. Among them, Cronus, the youngest and most ambitious Titan, would play a pivotal role in shaping the destiny of the cosmos. As the Titans assert their presence, the struggle for power and dominance becomes an inherent aspect of the divine narrative. Uranus, fearing the potential of his offspring to usurp his throne, imprisons them within Gaia, sparking a cycle of conflict and retribution that would define the divine order. Gaia, anguished by the plight of her children, plots with Cronus to overthrow Uranus, setting the stage for the first great cosmic upheaval. This act of rebellion by Cronus against his father Uranus not only signifies the transfer of power from one generation to the next, but also establishes a precedent for the cyclical nature of divine rule, a theme that recurs throughout Greek mythology. The overthrow of Uranus by Cronus, however, is but a precursor to further divine strife. Cronus, now the ruler of the cosmos, becomes consumed by the same fear that plagued his father, the prophecy that he, too, would be overthrown by his own child. In a desperate bid to prevent this fate, Cronus devours his offspring, sowing the seeds of his eventual downfall and the rise of a new pantheon of gods, led by Zeus. This tale of creation, from chaos to the reign of the Titans, encapsulates the themes of birth, struggle, and succession that are central to Greek mythology. It portrays a universe born out of disorder, shaped by the ambitions and conflicts of its earliest beings, and governed by a constant tension between order and chaos, power and usurpation. The narrative sets the stage for the epic sagas that follow, including the Titanomachy and the rise of Olympus, illustrating the intricate and often tumultuous relationships among the gods and their impact on the fabric of the cosmos. The Titanomachy, often heralded as the first great war for power within the cosmos, marks a defining saga in Greek mythology. this epic conflict between the Titans, the older generation of gods led by Cronus, and the Olympians, the younger deities spearheaded by Zeus, embodies the climactic struggle for divine supremacy and the establishment of a new cosmic order. The roots of this celestial war trace back to the prophesied downfall of Cronus, who, in his dread of being overthrown by his offspring, consumed his children at birth. Yet, through cunning and fate, Zeus was spared this grim fate, spirited away at birth to be raised in secret. Matured and emboldened by the injustice meted out to him and his siblings, Zeus would emerge as the architect of revolt, determined to challenge Cronus and liberate his consumed brethren. The Titanomachy was not merely a battle, but a 10-year-long cataclysm that shook the foundations of the universe. The conflict was vast, pitting the seasoned might and wisdom of the Titans against the youthful vigor and resolve of the Olympians. The battleground was the sprawling expanse of Thessaly, where the forces clashed with such ferocity that the very earth trembled and the skies roared with the tumult of battle. Zeus, having freed his siblings from Cronus's grasp, rallied not only the Olympians, but also a host of allies. Among these were the Cyclopes, forgers of Zeus's thunderbolts, and the Centaumenes, 100-handed giants whose strength and weapons turned the tide of battle. Each god played their role, from Poseidon, who wielded his trident to stir seas and earthquakes, to Hera, who marshaled her divine wisdom and strategy. The war culminated in a maelstrom of divine power as Zeus unleashed a fury of thunderbolts upon the Titans, a display of power so overwhelming that it signaled the downfall of the old order. The Titans were vanquished, many cast into the dark pit of Tartarus, a prison deep within the earth. This victory was not just a triumph over Cronus and his ilk, but a symbolic overthrow of an outdated regime, paving the way for a new era of governance and autonomy under the Olympians. In the aftermath of the Titanomachy, the cosmos was reborn. Zeus, alongside his brothers Poseidon and Hades, divided the universe among themselves to gods. Zeus claimed the heavens, Poseidon the seas, and Hades the underworld. This division of realms established a balance of power, a structured hierarchy that would govern the interactions of gods and mortals alike. The Titanomachy, therefore, stands as a monumental event in Greek mythological history, symbolizing the eternal cycle of struggle and rebirth that defines the cosmos. It highlights themes of resistance against tyranny, quest for justice, and the inevitable shift from old to new. Through this legendary conflict, the Olympians asserted their sovereignty, setting the stage for a golden age of gods and men. A time of heroes, and the rich tapestry of myths that continue to enchant and inspire to this day. The Dominion of Olympus, established in the wake of the Titanomachy, heralded a new era of divine rule under the auspices of Zeus and his pantheon of gods. However, the celestial order was not without its internal strife and discord. The very fabric of Olympian rule was interwoven with tales of intrigue, betrayal, and challenges to authority, reflecting the complex dynamics of power and governance. Zeus, as the sovereign of the Olympian gods, wielded supreme authority, his will manifesting in the laws that govern both the divine and mortal realms. Yet, his reign was continuously tested by the ambitions, rivalries, and discontent among the gods themselves. Hera, his queen and sister, was often at the heart of Olympian conflict, her jealousy and wrath sparked by Zeus's numerous infidelities and the offspring. Olympus' machinations against Zeus's consorts and their progeny were not merely acts of spite, but underscored the fragility of divine alliances and the personal vendettas that could disrupt the celestial order. The rivalries extended beyond the marital strife of Zeus and Hera. Athena and Poseidon's contest over the patronage of Athens demonstrated how the quest for honor and recognition among the gods could spill into the mortal world, influencing the fates of cities and their inhabitants. This rivalry, decided by the offering deemed more valuable to the people of Athens, highlighted the gods' deep engagement with human affairs and their desire for reverence and devotion. Hephaestus's revenge against Hera for rejecting him due to his deformity further exemplifies the internal conflicts of Olympus. Crafting a magnificent throne that ensnared Hera upon her sitting, Hephaestus demanded his rightful place among the gods in exchange for a release. This incident not only speaks to the cleverness and resilience of Hephaestus, but also to the theme of retribution and reconciliation that pervades the divine relationships within Olympus. Prometheus's defiance in bestowing fire upon humanity against Zeus's decree marks another pivotal challenge to Olympian authority. This act of rebellion was met with severe punishment, underscoring Zeus's determination to maintain divine supremacy and order. Yet, it also reflects the complex interactions between gods and mortals, highlighting themes of benevolence, punishment, and the transfer of knowledge. The intrigues and conflicts within Olympus serve as a mirror to the human condition, illustrating that even the divine are not immune to jealousy, ambition, and the struggle for power. These narratives enrich the tapestry of Greek mythology, offering insights into the virtues and vices that shape existence. The governance of Olympus, though marked by periods of strife, ultimately exemplifies the quest for balance and justice, with Zeus's authority reaffirmed through each challenge. Through these stories, the ancient Greeks explored the dynamics of power, morality, and the eternal tension between order and chaos. The relationship between humanity and the gods in Greek mythology is a complex web of interaction, intervention, and influence, highlighting a dynamic that is both nurturing and punitive, beneficent and capricious. This intricate bond reflects the ancient Greeks' understanding of the divine as an integral part of the natural world and human existence, where the gods played an active role in the affairs of mortals, shaping destinies and intervening in their trials and tribulations. The gods were seen as protectors and patrons of cities, natural phenomena, and aspects of daily life, thereby ensuring that every element of human existence was under the aegis of a divine watch. Athena's patronage of Athens, Apollo's association with music and medicine, and Demeter's domain over agriculture are just a few examples of how the divine permeated the mortal world, offering protection, guidance, and gifts to humanity. However, this relationship was not one-sided. It required reverence, worship, and sacrifices from mortals to maintain favor and avoid the gods' wrath. The tales of heroic exploits and divine interventions are numerous and varied, each illustrating different facets of the gods' involvement in human affairs. The labors of Heracles, undertaken as penance for crimes instigated by Hera's jealousy, showcased the trials imposed by the gods as well as their capacity for redemption and reward. The journey of Odysseus, fraught with challenges posed by Poseidon's anger and aided by Athena's wisdom, exemplifies the gods' direct impact on an individual's fate, guiding and obstructing according to their whims and conflicts. is this act of stealing fire from the gods and bestowing it upon humanity symbolizes the transfer of knowledge and the sparking of civilization, highlighting a pivotal moment where divine benevolence and punitive wrath collide. This act of defiance against Zeus's will lead to Prometheus's eternal punishment, but also underscored the gods' vested interest in the progression and welfare of human society, albeit within the bounds they set. The relationship between gods and mortals was also marked by instances of love, both passionate and platonic. The numerous liaisons between gods and mortals, such as the union of Zeus and Leda or Poseidon and Amphitrite, often resulted in the birth of heroes and demigods, blending divine lineage with human, thereby enriching the mythic tradition with stories of extraordinary beings who straddled both worlds. This divine-human dynamic, with its blend of intervention, retribution, and guidance, served not only as a means of explaining natural phenomena, social customs, and historical events, but also as a reflection of the human condition, with its aspirations, vulnerabilities, and ethical dilemmas. The gods, and their interactions with humanity, embodied the virtues and vices inherent in human nature, serving as both exemplars and cautionary figures. Through these narratives, the ancient Greeks explored the themes of justice, morality, and the quest for knowledge, understanding the gods as both the source of and solution to human suffering and triumph. The relationship between humanity and the gods in Greek mythology, therefore, is a testament to the enduring quest to understand the cosmos and our place within it, bridging the divine and the mortal through stories that continue to fascinate and inspire. The throne of Zeus, within the grand narrative of Greek mythology, symbolizes far more than mere sovereignty over the gods and the universe. It represents the culmination of cosmic order and justice, the balance between power and responsibility, and the enduring quest for harmony within the cosmos. As the ruler of Olympus and the king of gods, Zeus embodies the principles of law, order, and governance, building his authority to maintain balance and dispense justice, both among the divine and in the mortal realm. Zeus's ascension to the throne was achieved through struggle and conflict, notably marked by the Titanomachy, where he led the Olympian gods to victory over the Titans. This victory was not merely a triumph of power, but a foundational shift in the cosmic order from the old chaotic rule of the Titans to a new era of justice and equilibrium under Zeus. His rulership signifies the establishment of a divine order based on laws and decrees that all beings, mortal and immortal, are bound to respect. The thunderbolt, Zeus's iconic weapon, is a symbol of his authority and power to enforce divine will and order. It signifies his role as the protector of justice, using his might to uphold the laws of gods and men. The thunderbolt also embodies the destructive aspect of Zeus's power, a reminder of the potential consequences of defying divine law and the natural order. Zeus's throne is also a point of convergence for the divine and mortal worlds. Through his numerous liaisons and interactions with mortals, Zeus influences the fates of heroes and nations, guiding the course of history and the development of civilization. These relationships, often resulting in the birth of demigods and heroes, bridge the gap between the divine and human realms, integrating the gods into the everyday lives of mortals and ensuring their active participation in the human story. Furthermore, the throne symbolizes the complexities and challenges of leadership. Despite his supreme power, Zeus must must navigate the intrigues, rivalries, and desires of the gods, reflecting the nuanced balance required to maintain peace and order within Olympus and the wider universe. His judgments and decisions, though sometimes flawed, were driven by a desire to maintain stability and justice, highlighting the burdens and responsibilities that come with power. Zeus's marriage to Hera, the queen of the gods, and his relationships with his siblings and children are emblematic of the dynamics of power, loyalty, and conflict within the divine family. These relationships are a microcosm of the broader cosmic order, illustrating how love, jealousy, ambition, and reconciliation shape the universe's functioning. In essence, Zeus's throne is not just a symbol of divine authority, but a representation of the moral and ethical foundations of the cosmos. It embodies the ideals of justice, order, harmony, and wisdom that govern the universe, reflecting the ancient Greeks' understanding of the world's inherent order and the divine's role in maintaining balance and justice. Through the figure of Zeus and the symbolism of his throne, Greek mythology explores the themes of power, leadership, and the eternal quest for balance between the divine will and the human condition.
Oh.